Windows 11 Home versus Pro. What's the difference and is it worth it? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. For consumers and small businesses, Windows 11 comes in two flavors or editions, Home and Pro. Other editions are targeted for educational and corporate use, so I'm going to focus on the consumer choices here. The Pro Edition comes with a few additional features that you may or may not care about. We'll go over those. And of course, the Pro Edition also costs a little bit more than Home. The ultimate question we'll try to answer is whether those additional features are worth the additional cost. Whether you have Home or Pro isn't going to be obvious by looking at your computer. The core features of Windows 11 is still Windows 11. The start menu, the taskbar, the Windows behavior, default applications, gaming features, Windows Update, Windows Security, all that is present in both. You actually need to dive into the Settings app to determine which edition you actually have. The difference revolves around features included in the Pro Edition and not Home. From a consumer point of view, the most relevant features are BitLocker, Group Policy Editor, Remote Desktop Host, and Hyper-V. BitLocker. Windows 11 Pro Edition allows you to manage BitLocker encryption via the user interface. The Home Edition includes device encryption, which is based on BitLocker, but it's well hidden and not easily managed. Group Policy Editor. Often referenced in various system tweaking and configuration instructions, gpedit.msc, the Group Policy Editor, is in Pro Editions only. Home Edition users wanting to make the equivalent changes must edit the registry directly. For example, it's not that uncommon for sites like askleo to suggest a change requiring either gpedit or a registry change in order to fix a problem or change some kind of Windows behavior. Remote Desktop Host. Remote Desktop lets you connect from one computer to another as if you were in front of that remote computer. You can use Remote Desktop Host to connect to a computer running Windows 11 Pro Edition remotely if Remote Desktop Host is enabled. You cannot connect to a computer running Windows 11 Home using Remote Desktop. You'd have to use some kind of third-party equivalent tool like Chrome Remote Desktop or TeamViewer or any of several other tools instead. Hyper-V virtualization. This allows you to create and run virtual machines within Windows 11 Pro. Once again, Windows 11 Home Edition users would need to install third-party software to perform the same task. Less common or less applicable features for consumers available only in Pro include assigned access or kiosk mode, in which restricts a login account's access to a single or limited number of applications. As the name implies, it's intended for devices, perhaps public-facing, that are intended to serve a specific function. Joining Active Directory or Azure AD. Rather than using local accounts or Microsoft accounts to control machine access, accounts are centrally managed, typically in a corporate environment. And then enterprise-level Windows Update for Business, essentially centralized update policies for, again, large environments. Why might you choose Home? If your needs are simple, as they are for most average consumers, then Home may very well be right for you. Home is plenty for casual home use, family use, gamers, and the like. As long as you don't feel you need extra control over things like BitLocker or remote access, and you don't expect to make many of these system tweaks that might be made easier by the Group Policy Editor, Home should be plenty. And, of course, if you're price sensitive, and who isn't these days, Home is cheaper. Why might you choose Pro? Well, you'd consider the Pro Edition if you need access to your machine remotely using Remote Desktop, you need to manage BitLocker, you need to run virtual machines running Hyper-V, you want to make tweaks to your system settings easily using the Group Policy Editor, and, of course, it's in your budget. Hyper-V is perhaps the most relevant for me, though being able to fire up the Group Policy Editor at times has also been convenient. If you have Windows 11 Home and you want to upgrade to Pro, it's actually not difficult. In the Settings app, visit the Activation page. You can either enter a product key you've purchased or visit the Microsoft Store to purchase the upgrade in place. In either case, Windows will just reconfigure itself and switch from Home to Pro. If you have Windows 11 Pro and you want to downgrade to Home, sorry, there's no similar path. A reinstall is actually the only approach that I'm aware of. I've long recommended Windows Pro Edition over Home, mostly because of Group Policy Editor and Remote Desktop, and now better BitLocker control. However, I also understand that those are not priorities for everyone and that the cost can be an issue. Hopefully, though, you now have enough information to help you make your own decision based on your own needs, your own priorities, and of course, your own budget. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/180324. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.